Hi everybody, this is Bronislava for Handmade Rukodelky. I'm here on our town's path. Oh, I have to go and turn around because my dogs went around me. It's fabulous. They built this little trail in the middle of the town, which I absolutely love. And you can see this absolutely beautiful wooden bridge. You see it? It's fabulous. Anyway, so it's great to take a walk from knitting and crocheting and editing videos and writing patterns and blogging and putting everything on social media. It's good for me and it's good for my dogs. Look at them, they're having a great time. Oh, and I almost forgot, this is what we're gonna be doing. Look at this, we're gonna be today crocheting. Oops, they're pulling. My dogs are pulling. So this is what we're gonna be crocheting today. This glove. Alright? I will be using a leftover from Snuggly Wuggly dip dye yarn. Alright, and this is what I was doing so far. So I used the light color. I used it for the cuff. And then from the outside, I use the darker shade for the palm part, okay? And I am working with, again, with 3.75 millimeter hook, okay? So this is what we will be doing. First, we will make the cuff, and then we'll work on our palm part. The cuff is very easy. It's just the repetition of one row after we set up first two rows, okay? Or basically chain and a first row, and then the next row is repetition. We will start with chain 37. So make 37 chains. After you make a knot, make 37 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37. Now we need to join into circle and make sure it's not twisted. So just basically use the thumb and rub it against the top of the chain all the way over here, and then turn it slowly and join into the first chain, okay, with a slip stitch. So the 37th stitch is above the first stitch, okay, and this is going to create 36 stitches all around. Well, I will be actually working on the back over here, on the back of my stitches, and I think you might see these. This is the front, right, and this is the back, and each back has a bump. You see these bumps? Let me show it to you from the side. You can see these bumps on the side. That's where I will be putting. This is first bump over here, which you really cannot see as well. So this is where I will be putting my hook. But if you want, you can do it right here below these 1 and 2. You see, here is one and here is second one. So you can do it here if it's gonna be hard on you, okay? But I will be doing it into the back of my stitch, into the bumps. First, we will make chain two. Why I am making chain two, even that we will be working with double crochet stitch, is because when we are working with front post and back post double crochet stitch, they are actually kind of shorter. So I use only two chain stitches to start with. So after I made my two chain stitches, my next stitch is going to be, so you can go here, but I will be going into the back of my first stitch, which is right here. All right, let me just push this one down so it doesn't confuse us. So I will go into the back of my first stitch of that bump and I will make my first double crochet stitch. Yarn over, and my next double crochet stitch is going to go into my second bump. Okay. And I will continue making 35 double crochet stitches into all these bumps. 35 double crochet stitches because the first two chain stitches right in here, they count as DC, okay? So you do the same or do it your way, whichever way you prefer. So make 35 double crochet stitches all around, okay? I crocheted my 35 double crochet stitches and I'm ready to join. But if I join, let me show you, if I join into the circle, I have kind of like a space right here and I don't like it. So what I will do over here, I will take my last double crochet stitch. I do that sometimes just to wing it, or you know, just to make sure that it looks better. So I'll take my last double crochet back and I will make two double crochet here together. Okay, double crochet two together. So I will go and make yarn over and pull yarn through the stitch, yarn over, pull yarn over through the stitch right here. Okay, then I will pull my yarn through all four of these stitches and through the last two stitches, and now I will join in a second chain because we had only two chains, right? So I will join, and look how good it looks. You see, I don't have any hole in there yet. We still have those 36 stitches. We did not add any stitch, okay? This is going to be our second row. And what we will do is we will repeat. We will do repetition of two stitches. First, we will start with chain two, one and two. And remember I told you, because the front post double crochet is shorter, that's why only two chain stitches in here, okay? And we will be repeating two stitches for front post double crochet and back post double crochet. Front post double crochet, back post double crochet. So we will do it this way. Yarn over, and then you will go between these two, into these two holes, and the double crochet is in the middle, right? So you will go and put your hook in the hole before double crochet, out the hole after double crochet, pull yarn through, and make your double crochet. Okay? So that's front post double crochet. Now the next one is going to be through the back. Again, we will go and do yarn over, and you will go in the back. You will put, insert your hook in the back through the hole into the other hole. Okay, so you just basically put your hook in the back of the double crochet, pull the yarn through, and make double crochet. Finish your double crochet. And this is the back post double crochet, so it's pulled through the back. Okay, and now we will do the same thing again. We will repeat these two stitches. Yarn over through those two holes around that double crochet stitch, pull yarn through, and make double crochet stitch. And now through the back, okay? So yarn over, you go in the back, pull yarn through, and make double crochet, finish double crochet stitch. And now we will continue like this all the way to the end until you have this one last stitch left over, and I will show you how to work with that, okay? So just do that. First, do the front post double crochet stitch, and then do the back post double crochet stitch. In front post double crochet stitch, and back post double crochet stitch. And I'll see you when I am finished. Basically at the end of my row, you will finish all the way here. You leave that last stitch. Okay, I am back. And if you count these front post double crochet stitches, the ones that are raised up, you should have 17 of them. This is my 17th right here. Okay, and now we will make one more front post double crochet stitch along this DC two together, double crochet two together, you know, when we were trying to make the hole to be less visible. Okay, so we will do that. Okay, this is the front post double crochet, because this was our back post double crochet, so next one is front post double crochet. And now this chain two right here acts as a double crochet stitch, but we will treat it as a back post double crochet, but we're not going to do anything with it. We will just connect, we will join it with a slip stitch. Okay, so this would be like front post and this would be like back post. And now we will do our two chain stitches, which is going to act as a back post double crochet stitch. Okay, and then we will start again with the front post double crochet stitch and the back post double crochet stitch right there. And front post double crochet stitch and back post double crochet stitch. So where you had front post, that's where you will do front post, and where you had back post, that's where you will have back post. Okay, and again you will have 17 of them, and then you will do your 18th front post here at the end and join into the two chain. And this is our third row, so I will finish it and I will show you one more time how to finish the row. This will be my 18th raised front post. Okay, so we will make our 18th front post, and then this, like I said, acts as a back post, which is chain two. So 1, 2, this is where we will make our join. Okay, we will join it. You see how it looks? Okay, and we continue. So again, chain two, and then all the front and back posts. This is my row four, by the way. And just continue like this until you have as many rows as you want, or 10 rows according to my pattern, written pattern, which will be again published on my blog. So I'm finished with my 10 rows, okay, just like in here, and I already cut off my yarn here, and I will be continuing with my dark pink. You see, with this yarn, since it's variegated, I would have, if I would continue with this one, I would have one entirely light fingerless glove, and then another one would be a combination of light and dark. So I just wanted to be to make sure that I will have these gloves approximately similar. Okay, so now I will be working with my dark shade. On our palm part, we will be working actually with the more lacy pattern, okay? And First, we will be working around first two rows, and in a third row, we will start working back and forth for several rows, and then we will go back into working around. Okay, so that's our plan for making this part. Okay, we are switching to our new yarn. Okay, and I will actually make this light color really tight. I will weave it in. I will make it even tighter when I will be weaving it in. And over here we will make chain, first chain, okay? And then in the same stitch right here, make a double crochet stitch. Okay, and actually I will use both strands, and now I will make, and then I will use one strand just to make sure, you know, that it's it doesn't unravel. Okay, so that's our first stitch, and now we will make shells. So we will skip two stitches, and in the third one we will make shell. And our shell is done with 5 double crochet stitches in the same stitch, into this stitch, 5 double crochet stitches, okay? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we will skip 1, 2 stitches, and we will make single crochet stitch into the third stitch. And we will repeat, skip 2 stitches and make shell stitches in here. So 5 double crochet stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And again, skip 2 stitches into third one, put 1 single crochet stitch there, okay? And repeat all the way to the end until you finish with double crochet stitch, and then you will, shell, and then you go and then you will connect it into, slip stitch it into the single crochet stitch right there, okay? I will show you how to do that. I will see you when I am finished with this row. I am finished with my 6 shells. Okay, but now we need to join it, and we will join it into this single crochet stitch. This is our 12th row, and we will do it this way. Again, we will do repeats. We will crochet 5 chain stitches, 1, 2, 3. These 3 chain stitches will represent double crochet stitch, okay? Now we will make 2 more, that's 4 and 5, because we do always have 2 chain stitches between single crochet stitch and double crochet stitch, okay? So now at the top of this shell, in a third stitch, 1, 2, 3, we will make, don't do yarn over, I just did something wrong, okay? We will do single crochet stitch. Okay, so single crochet stitch here. Now chain 2, 1, 2, and double crochet stitch between these 2 shells into the single crochet stitch from the previous row. Okay, so here we will do double crochet stitch. This is where we need to do double crochet stitch. So at the top we will do single crochet stitch, but again we need to do chain two, one, two chains, and single crochet right here. And again, chain two, and double crochet stitch over here into the single crochet between the shells. And chain two, and single crochet all the way to the end. And I'm at the end, and I made my single crochet above my sixth shell. I need to do chain two, one, two, and now is the time to join into the third chain stitch. One, two, three, join right there. Okay, very good. Now we will do chain one and we will repeat row 11. So in our 13 row we will do the same like row 11, except the ending, the end will be different. Okay, so do it like row 11 and I will start you up, but then I will show you how to finish the 13th row. Okay, so we did chain one and we will do single crochet in the same stitch. And then we will do into this single crochet stitch, we will do our fan. So this is going to be one, two, three, four, and five. And now we will make single crochet stitch right above this double crochet stitch. Okay, we skipped two stitches. Let me show you. We skipped one and two stitches, and we will make a single crochet stitch right there. Okay, and we will repeat again. We will skip two stitches and we will make into this third stitch, we will make our shell. Okay, shell. It looks like fan, but it's really a shell. Fans have usually one chain stitches between double crochet stitches. But I always say fan or shell. I use sometimes wrong expression, right? Okay, so that's four and one more. And now again, I will put my single crochet right here. And repeat this all the way to the end, and then I will show you what I did at the end, okay? You can rewind if you need to, you can rewind. Rewind my videos if you need to go and see something again and again. So I finished my sixth shell in this row, and instead of joining, okay, we will make one more single crochet stitch in here, okay, right there where you did the first single crochet stitch. One more. It's because we will be now working back and forth, so we can make this opening. You see this opening? So we will be working now back. So turn, and from now on, I mean, in this row, we will work on the wrong side. So again, we will actually make five chain stitches, one, two, three, four, five, just like in a row 12, okay, and we will make single crochet stitch right here, and then chain two, one, two, and then over here between the shell stitches into the single crochet stitch, we will make double crochet stitch, chain two again, one and two, and again single crochet stitch at the top of the shell. and chain 2 and double crochet all the way to the end, where I will show you how to finish it. So I'm finished with my 14th row, almost finished actually, okay, and we will make chain 2 and into this single crochet, which is actually the very first one from previous row. You see, we did we made chain 5 over here in this one, and here we have that second one. We had 2 single crochet stitches, you remember? Okay, so we need to make double crochet stitch into this single crochet stitch. Okay, so yarn over and double crochet stitch right there. Now we will turn again, and we will be working in a 15th row, and we will be doing it this way. It's going to be similar to the row 13, okay? So chain 1 and single crochet stitch into the same stitch right there, right above that double crochet stitch from previous row, okay? And now we will make our shell. So again, into the single crochet stitch, 5 double crochet stitches. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we will make single crochet stitch into our double crochet stitch from previous row, single crochet stitch, okay, and we will repeat and do this all the way to the end, and I will show you again how to do that, okay? So we will make 5 double crochet stitches here, and then single crochet stitch in our double crochet stitch. So I am at the end of my 15th row, and I will make a single crochet into third chain. 1, 2, 3, right there, okay? Make a single crochet stitch. Okay, so it should look like this. And now we will turn again, and we will work on our 14th row, okay? So you can rewind, and you can watch how to do the 14th row, and then you will do row 15 again, and again row 14, okay? So rewind the video and just watch if you need to, if you don't remember how you did it, okay? So it's going to be from now on, from this point, it's going to be row 14, row 15, and row 14 again. And when I'm finished with these 3 rows, I will show you what I am doing next. Oh, this is wrong. I'm talking and I forgot what I was supposed to do. Okay, I'll show you what to do next. Otherwise, the video would be too long. And I don't want to do that. Also, you can follow written directions on my blog, okay? So, I am at the end of my 18th row, okay? I did my single crochet stitch above the shell, 2 chain, and I have to join over here into the single crochet stitch with double crochet stitch. Okay, I'm starting to be confused over here. And now we will continue just like we did in row 11, okay, because over here in a row, this row, which is 19th, we will be joining it, okay? So when we get to the end over here, we will join the row, okay? So what we need to do is we need to do chain and single crochet stitch. And now we will do our shells, okay? Here, single crochet stitch here, shell right here, single crochet, okay, and continue just like that. Just like row 11, you can replay your row 11, you know, you can rewind and replay it, okay? So when I'm finished with my 19th row, which is like row 11, I will show you how I am connecting it right there. So this is end of my 19th row, and what I still need to do is my single crochet stitch into the third chain, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, is it third chain? Actually, it's 1, 2, 3 right here. Okay, any day now, right? So single crochet stitch right here, okay? So it kind of creates that edge over here, and now we will join into the second single crochet right there at the beginning of our row. We will slip stitch it, okay? And now we will start working the same way like we were doing over here. So this row actually is going to be like our 12th row. Okay, so we will do five chain stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and then single crochet, right? And if you need to, you can replay my 12th row, how I was working on it, okay? And I am, after I am finished here, and after I join into my third chain over here, when I'm at the end of the row, what I will do is, I will do one more row of my shell stitches, okay? Which is going to be just like row 11. I am finished with my row 20, okay? And so what we need to do is join it. So I made my single crochet here, chain 2, right? And now I have to join it into my third chain stitch right here with a slip stitch. Okay, we will make one chain and single crochet in the same stitch. Okay, single crochet. Now we will be making again our shells, shell here, single crochet, shell here, all the way to the end where you finish with the shell right here, and then you will join it into this single crochet stitch, okay? And it is exactly like row 11, and this is our 21st row. So you do that, and I will see you when I'm all finished. I'm finished with my 21st row, and I am joining it into that one single crochet, one more chain for a knot, and we will cut this off and weave in all our ends. So I'm finished with my gloves, and if you made gloves, fingerless gloves, or also it could be also wrist warmers, right? Anyway, so if you made them, you can go and share your images with me. It would be fabulous. And I'm done. This is it for today. Thank you so much, and I will see you another time.
You see, look at this. You Didn't they do a great job? I love it. I love the wood panels on this little bridge. And look, there are some houses right there. You might see them. How pretty big houses there. Kids are probably home from school. Anyway, so I just wanted to share this with you. So go for a walk. So you don't just sit and knit or sit and crochet. All right, see you later.